Every VPN has its pros and cons. In today's NordVPN review, I'm going to be going over all the ones in this app so you can decide if it's right for you. I'm starting off this review of NordVPN with one of the more entertaining reasons that it's used, and that's to seriously upgrade your streaming and torrenting experience. Unbeknownst to some, you can actually use a VPN to unlock tons of hidden content simply by switching the location of your IP address. Using NordVPN for Netflix access is just one option. And since there's no buffering, binging all your newly found shows is smooth and consistent. Keep in mind, not all VPNs are successfully able to stream and torrent at such high lag-free speeds. NordVPN uses its unique NordLink's tunneling protocol, which not only increases the overall security, but allows for some of the fastest speeds on the market. And whether you're using NordVPN for Apple TV, Netflix, or your other favorite platform, there are plenty of servers to choose from, with 6,200 available in 111 countries. Now, if you're looking to try out torrenting with NordVPN, they have some specialty servers just for that. These create a straightforward path for the data to download through, all while safely encrypting it. And if you'd also like to get all these streaming and torrenting benefits for yourself, be sure to grab the exclusive discount that I've left in the description. All right, the next part of this NordVPN review is the most crucial to keeping your personal data and online activity safe, and that is the security and privacy measures. This provider opted for a jurisdiction in Panama, a place with privacy-friendly laws that don't allow for users' information to be shared to the government. Their fourth independent no-logs audit has recently been done, and it proved that all their claims to secure your connection and keep your private information actually private are up to par. Now, the type of encryption used by any VPN is going to determine the strength of protection. And NordVPN uses a couple of the most modern options on the market. Not to mention, all the subscriptions include a bunch of useful security features that have always been must-haves in my book. Split tunneling is a great way to route the VPN through certain apps and sites, so you can have a balance of local and international content. The kill switch ensures that your device is only connected to the network while it's protected. And the dark web monitoring scans the dark web 24/7 to check if any of your credentials have been leaked. So all those features add a layer of security to your browsing experience, but there are also some features that simply add lots of convenience. For example, the specialty servers are easy to access and they all assist in making specific tasks more functional. The obfuscated server essentially masks the fact that you're using a VPN, which is going to help bypass any sites that may have restricted the use of VPNs. The double VPN servers add double the protection, aptly named, while the onion over VPN ones route your data through the Tor network, which is harder for third parties to access. Okay, as you can see, the NordVPN app already provides you with tons of security and convenience, but there's another feature that really elevates its protection to a near antivirus level. Threat protection continuously works in the background to block you from encountering multiple kinds of online threats. So there are lots of sites out there teeming with malware, and this feature is going to prevent you from clicking on an infected one that could potentially affect your device. And similar to most antivirus apps out there, threat protection automatically scans each file that you download to ensure that they're totally free from viruses and malware. I also really appreciate that the trackers will no longer be able to follow my online activity and collect information about my browsing habits. And of course, my browsing experience is greatly improved thanks to the ad blocking powers that remove those annoying ads. Some of you are going to notice that this NordVPN review doesn't include any port forwarding option, which some other providers do have. Personally, I find that it isn't a very secure method to remotely access other devices. Plus, the meshnet feature is an excellent and safer substitute. If you frequently want to share media with friends and family, this tool is really handy. Here, you can create a private connection on up to 60 devices where you can safely be able to share thousands of files at the same time. One noteworthy factor is that for both the NordVPN extension and mobile app, the threat protection feature will only come in a Lite version. While the fully functioning one works without a VPN connection, the Lite needs always to be connected to a VPN server. For all you Mac users out there, keep in mind that you're gonna have two different app options to choose from with just some slight differences. The web version is easy to download directly from their website and comes with more updates. The app version can be downloaded right from the App Store, although it's compatible only with devices updated to 10.15 or higher operating systems. And aside that its threat protection is less effective than the web version, most of the other features are fully functioning. Okay, I'm gonna add that regardless if you're using a desktop app, a browser extension, or a mobile app, all of the interfaces are very user-friendly and organized. The dashboard is minimalistic with all the features being easily accessible, and you can download NordVPN on most major platforms. And recently they upgraded their simultaneous device allotment from 6 to 10. So that's nice. Ultimately, there's currently no GUI available on Linux, and the router setup might be a bit complicated for beginners. But as far as NordVPN pricing goes, the subscriptions are really affordable, especially if you choose a long-term plan. There's generally a good price-to-value ratio overall. For example, if I compare it to ExpressVPN, their plans include less features and cost more. Now, if you're looking to test the waters a little bit before committing, there is a NordVPN free trial available. It's got a 30-day money-back guarantee as well, which means there's no risk for your first month. Keep in mind, though, that the NordVPN trial can only be activated on an Android phone. After that, you're free to log in on any other device, but still, it's a bit inconvenient. Also, auto renewal is automatically enabled and the prices may have fluctuated since your sign up date, so be sure to check all your settings. Okay, to sum up everything, NordVPN is one of the few providers on the market that works constantly to limit its cons. No Apple TV? Sorted. Not enough devices? We hear you. So even the cons I listed in today's video will likely become pros in the future. If you're interested in a more in-depth review of NordVPN, be sure to check out my other videos and tutorials. And thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.